Christ. The old has gone, the new has come. We are reconciled by love. We are reconciled by love. And this is our new song we sing to the King of Heaven. This is our new song we bring. After all you've given, we stand before you redeemed. As your children, this is the new song we sing.
We who were once so far away are brought near by your blood. The barrier has been destroyed by your grace. We freely
King of Heaven, this is a new song we bring. After all you've given, we stand before you redeemed. As your children, this is a new song we sing. Stand as your redeemed, your redeemed. And this is a new song we sing to the King of Heaven. This is a new song we bring. After all you've given, we stand before you redeemed. As your children,
friends, welcome to Worship with the Faith community here at Cross of Hope Lutheran Church. I hope you enjoy my new liturgical mask. My mother-in-law has made me a full set of liturgical masks in all of the colors. Be sure to tune in next week on Reformation Sunday to see if the mask color has changed. I'll give you a hint, it will. It's a blessing to gather here in worship during this time of pandemic. I pray that you are safe at home and that you are wearing your masks. If you need a mask, contact the church. We have some that have been lovingly made, and we can be certain to get some to you. We'll continue here held together as we are at all times, but especially during these times, held together by God's love. And as a way to remember, to honor, and to believe in this truth and promise, we'll light a candle as a symbol of God's presence, God's love holding us together. And we'll do it again here with our family promise. Candle as we end our week of hosting there, our week of monetary hosting, which again, we just so much greatly appreciate your continued generosity through our partners in ministry at Family Promise. I'll invite you now into this call to worship. Worship the Lord in holy splendor. Tell of his salvation from day to day. Sing to the Lord, bless his name. Tell of his salvation from day to day. Say among the nations, the Lord is king. The world is firmly established. It shall never be moved. Tell of his salvation from day to day.
The fruit of all creation, thanks be to God. For these gifts to every nation, thanks be to God. For the plowing, sowing, reaping, silent growth while we are sleeping, future needs in earth safekeeping, thanks be to God. In the just reward of labor, Christ's will is done. In the help we give our neighbor, God's will is done. In our woven clothes we're caring for the hungry and despairing. In the harvest we are sharing, God's will be done. For the harvest of the Spirit, thanks be to God. For the good we all inherit, thanks be to God. For the of all that love has found us, thanks be to God.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Sovereign God, raise your throne in our hearts. Created by you, let us live in your image. Created for you, let us act for your glory. Redeemed by you, let us give you what is yours. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
A reading from Isaiah. Thus says the Lord to his anointed, to Cyrus, whose right hand I have grasped to subdue nations before him, and strip kings of their robes, to open doors before him, and the gates shall not be closed. I will go before you and level the mountains. I will break in pieces the doors of bronze and cut through the bars of iron. I will give you the treasures of darkness and riches hidden in secret places, so that you may know that it is I, the Lord, the God of Israel, who call you by your name. For the sake of my servant Jacob and Israel, my chosen, I call you by your name. I surname you, though you do not know me. I am the Lord, and there is no other. Besides me, there is no God. I arm you, though you do not know me, so that they may know, from the rising of the sun and from the west, that there is no one besides me. I am the Lord, there is no other. I form light and create darkness. I make weal and create woe. I, the Lord, do all these things. Word of God, word of life. A reading from 1 Thessalonians. Paul, Silvanus, and Timothy, to the Church of the Thessalonians in God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ, grace to you and peace. We always give thanks to God for all of you and mention you in our prayers, constantly remembering before our God and Father your work of faith and labor of love and steadfastness of hope in our Lord Jesus Christ. For we know, brothers and sisters, beloved by God, that he has chosen you, because our message of the gospel came to you not in word only, but also in power and in the Holy Spirit and with full conviction. Just as you know what kind of persons we proved to be among you for your sake. And you became imitators of us and of the Lord. For in spite of persecution, you received the word with joy inspired by the Holy Spirit, so that you became an example to all the believers in Macedonia, in Achaia. For the word of the Lord has sounded forth from you, not only in Macedonia and Achaia, but in every place your faith in God has become known, so that we have no need to speak about it. For the people of those regions report about us, what kind of welcome we had among you, and how you turned to God from idols to serve a living and true God, and to wait for his Son from heaven, whom he raised from the dead, Jesus, who rescues us from the wrath that is coming. Word of God, word of life. The Holy Gospel according to Matthew, the 22nd chapter. The Pharisees went and plotted to entrap Jesus in what he said. So they sent their disciples to him, along with the Herodians, saying, "Teacher, we know that you are sincere and teach the way of God in accordance with truth, and show deference to no one, for you do not regard people with partiality. Tell us then what you think. Is it lawful to pay taxes to the emperor or not?" But Jesus, aware of their malice, said, "Why are you putting me to the test, you hypocrites? Show me the coin used for the tax." And they showed him a denarius. Then he said to them, "Whose head is this, and whose title?" They answered, "The emperor's." Then he said to them, "Give therefore to the emperor the things that are the emperor's, and to God the things that are God's." When they heard this, they were amazed. And they left him and went away. The Gospel of the Lord.
All right, all my young friends, let's spend a few moments remembering together. Today's theme is remember to believe. One of the things that we talk about so often, especially here during our time together, is how much God loves you. And it's a common theme, but it's one that I really want you to hear again and again and again. Because again, there are times when it gets clouded and it gets hard to believe. It gets hard to believe that God loves me. And so join with me again today in remembering to believe that God loves you, that God loves me, that God loves all that God has made, and it is good. Thanks be to God for you these days, my friends, and I hope that you are safe and well, and I look so forward to seeing you. I long to see you soon. God bless you. Friends, won't you pray with me? You can repeat after me as we pray. Dear God, thank you for Jesus, who shows me how much you love me. Help me remember this today. We give you thanks in Jesus' name. Amen. Friends, grace to you and peace. In whatever it is that has brought you and that you have brought with you here today, anxiety or fear at the spike in COVID cases, grace to you and peace. Frustration or exhaustion of navigating this season of the journey, grace to you and peace. Joy or gratitude as we persevere and abound in hope, grace to you and peace. This simple greeting that Paul and the epistle writers used to greet the faithful communities of the church, the young church, is rich with promise and hope. The root of the Christian faith is God's grace revealed in Christ Jesus. And the hope in which we yet abound is the grace and peace yet made real and promised in the Holy Spirit. We continue our worship series today, Spiritual Heart Healthy Habits, under the theme, Remember to Believe. Grace to you and peace. What comes to mind when we have occasion to contemplate belief? What is it that you believe? I mean, have you ever encountered that question from someone, perhaps, well, what's your personal faith statement, or what's a faith statement? What do you believe? In confirmation, we invite our youth to write I Believe essays and reflect thoughtfully and prayerfully and considerately over their growth in life and faith thus far. So our preschool ministry is accredited through the Association of Christian Schools International. And during our last round of reaccreditation, the group asked for a statement of faith signed by the leadership group. And I thought for a while on the statement of faith because it's not necessarily as familiar to us Lutherans. I believe it's more common in the non-denominational circles. But for this young Lutheran pastor, I was kind of scrambling a little bit until I had my epiphany. The Apostles' Creed. You remember the Apostles' Creed? It's a statement of faith confessed at our baptism, I believe, affirmed at confirmation and in most new member receptions as we welcome new folks into the community. It's proclaimed often time as we gather in worship. Even though it is now a May rubric in evangelical Lutheran worship, and now in this season of mainly digital worship, many are choosing the not option of that rubric. But the Apostles' Creed is both a habit of our worship life together and our life in community. And with it and through it, we state our collective belief. We confess our faith together. Let's do that. Let's remember our Apostles' Creed together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sin, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. This historic statement of belief proclaims the basics of Christian faith. That God has created me along with all that exists. That Christ has redeemed me from all sin, death, and the power of evil, and how the Holy Spirit has called me into relationship with God and each other, and revealed to me the good news of the way of life that is in Jesus, and through forgiveness, through grace, makes me holy. This most likely familiar statement of faith helps us in the spiritual heart healthy habit of remembering to believe, both personally and communally, both for what has been accomplished in God's saving grace and for what it reveals in our remembering for today in this new season of life as the church, as people of faith, challenged by the pandemic and all that it has exposed in our journey and in our world. Grace and peace of God, yet now, today, as promised always. In today's epistle reading of the love letter that Paul sent to the young church in Thessalonica, a community in the capital of the Roman province of Macedonia, a context that was devoted to the imperial cult of Rome while still culturally Greek, for such a young community, the seemingly simple spiritual heart-healthy habit of remembering to believe was probably anything but simple in this context, especially without then Paul's presence. But what we hear in this first chapter of 1 Thessalonians is a powerful testimony of faith, of the lived reality of remembering to breathe, last week, of remembering to believe, a declaration of what God has done. Paul writes to them, "We always give thanks to God for all of you and mention you in our prayers, constantly remembering before our God and Father your work of faith and labor of love and steadfastness of hope in our Lord Jesus Christ." So from the very beginning here, Paul names the wholeness of God, faith, hope, and love. that he remembers is their way of life, this young community of faith, and in doing so trusts and believes in God that it continues to be this way in faithful work, in labors of love, and in steadfastness of hope. You can almost hear the present abounding of this young community. Faith in God, which they received not only in gospel word, but also in power and in the Holy Spirit, becomes known through living, through the very lives of the community of believers, persevering. Our living is influenced by our habits. Thus, the invitation to contemplate and cultivate spiritual, heart-healthy habits. The Apostles' Creed, as a habit of the church, the community of believers, both tells the world what we believe God to be and have done, and also becomes a spiritual, heart-healthy habit as it informs and impacts our daily living with what God continues to do, so that our faith in God becomes known. Paul proclaims this connection and turn into what God is doing through this young community. When he claims to them, "For the word of the Lord has sounded forth from you, not only in Macedonia and Achaia, but in every place your faith in God has become known, so that we have no need to speak about it." Again, it seems a simple habit. But habits like the Apostles' Creed have the power to move us from words simply about faith into faithful living. Living appropriately engaged in our pandemic-stricken world with grace and peace, both in word and in living. Faithfully, prayerfully, and thoughtfully participating in our civic life, in upcoming elections, and loving and serving our neighbors in need this week through our family promise hosting, but always in who we are as people of faith, remembering always to believe. Together, we remember this familiar statement of belief into the action statement that it is, from a place of created, beloved belonging to a life of gratitude, praise, service, and obedience to God. The Pharisees challenged Jesus with a trap in today's gospel. I don't know if you caught it there. "What do you believe, Jesus? What do you believe?" they asked. "Is it lawful to pay taxes to the emperor or not?" And knowing the trap, Jesus refused to be divided, used, or abused, and retorts, "Give the emperor the things that are the emperor's, and to God the things that are God's." When we put that beside our remembered statement of faith, the Apostles' Creed, our statement of belief proclaims the truth that God created me along with all that exists. And so to God belongs me and all there is. And so in response to God's faithfulness and grace, God's redeeming love in Christ Jesus, an active power through the Holy Spirit, we give our whole selves to God, and God's grace and peace will form us and sustain us for this new season of the journey. And this is a challenging time to be the church, dear friends. Grace to you and peace. Remember to believe. Amen.
Desperation, and all we know is doubt and fear. There is only one foundation. We believe in this
We believe in Jesus Christ. We believe in the Holy Spirit, and He's given us new life. We believe in the crucifixion. We believe that He conquered death. We believe in the resurrection, and He's coming back again. We believe. So let our faith be more than anthems, greater than the songs we sing. In our weakness and temptations, we believe, we believe, we believe in God the Father. We believe in Jesus Christ. We believe in the Holy Spirit, and He's given us new life. We believe in the crucifixion. We believe that He conquered death. We believe in the resurrection, and He's coming back again. Let the lost be found and the dead be raised in the here and now. Let love and faith, let the church live loud. Our God will say, we believe, and the gates of hell will not prevail, for the power of God has torn the veil. Now we know Your love will never fail. We believe, we believe, we believe in God the Father. We believe in Jesus Christ. We believe in the Holy Spirit, and He's given us new life. We believe in the crucifixion. We believe that He conquered death. We believe in the resurrection, and He's coming back. He's coming back again. He's coming back again. We believe. We believe.
Let us pray. With confidence in God's grace and mercy, let us pray for the church, the world, and all those in need. Gracious God, You call us by name and invite us to share Your good news. Send Your Holy Spirit among preachers, missionaries, and evangelists. We give thanks for the witness of Your servant Luke, the evangelist, whom the church commemorates today. Lord, in Your mercy. God of praise, the heavens and all creation declare Your salvation. From the rising of the sun to its setting, may the whole universe show forth Your goodness. Raise up devoted stewards of all that You have made. Lord, in Your mercy. God of all, may Your word of justice sound forth in every place. Restore divided nations and communities with reconciling truth. Lord, in Your mercy. God of light, we pray for those living with pain, illness, isolation, grief, anger, or doubt. Join their voices in a new song, assuring them that You call them each by name. We pray for Linda, Florence, David, Nick, John, Sherry, Jeff, Karen, Kathy, Wendy, Carol, Dante and Carmine, Bobby, Bill and Jim, Dolores, Harry, Robert, Norma, Ruth, Dee, Cap, Karis, Tony, Kay, Joel, and all those we name now aloud or in silence. Be near to those who grieve. Laura Burnt and family at the death of her Aunt Frances. Lord, in Your mercy. We give thanks for blessing and gift of relationship and for our partners in ministry, our school ministry, Family Promise, Operation 505, Compassion Beyond Borders, Luther House, Lutheran Family Services, Lutheran Advocacy Ministry, Grace Lutheran Church, Casper, Wyoming, and Highlands Lutheran Church, Denver, Colorado. Lord, in Your mercy. God of truth, You show no partiality. May your Spirit guide the work of justices, magistrates, court officials, and all vocations of the law, that your promise of restoration may be known. Lord, in your mercy. Living God, as you raised Jesus from the dead, so raise up those who have died in you. We give thanks for their witness, confident of your rescuing welcome for all. Lord, in your mercy. Listen as we call on you, O God, and enfold in your loving arms all for whom we pray. In the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
We continue to abound together in confidence and hope. Your continued giving through the ministries of Cross of Hope during this challenging time continues to be greatly appreciated. We continue now to give God glory through our offerings, through our work together, through this ministry of faith. God bless you in your continued giving.
We have raised a thousand voices just to lift your holy name. We will raise thousands more to sing of your beauty in this place. Oh, none can even fathom, no, not one define your worth. As we marvel in your presence to the ends of the earth, we give you glory, lifting up our hands and singing holy. You alone are worthy. We just want to touch your heart, Lord, touch your heart. Glory, lifting up our voice and singing holy. You alone are worthy. We just want to touch your heart, Lord, touch your heart. Fall down before you with all willing hearts we sing. In the greatness of your glory, it's so hard to even speak. There is nothing we can offer, no, nothing can repay. So we give you all our praises, and we lift our voice to sing. We give you glory, lifting up our hands and singing holy. You alone are worthy. We just want to touch your heart, Lord, touch your heart. Glory, lifting up our voice and singing holy. You alone are worthy. We just want to touch your heart, Lord, touch your heart. Our hope is drenched in you. Our faith has been renewed. We trust in your every word. Nothing else can even measure up to you. Holy, you alone are worthy. We just want to touch your heart, Lord, touch your heart. Glory, lifting up our voice and singing holy. You alone are worthy. We just want to touch your heart, Lord, touch your heart. Glory.
Friends, just a few notes on our continued journey together that continues as a blessing. Our Family Promise Week of Monetary Hosting ends today. Again, thank you for all of your generosity through our partners in ministry to impact the needs of our community. Look for a special drive-up donation day for Family Promise here in the very near future, so look for that. We'll continue celebrating the Lord's Supper together today. We'll have walk-up or drive-up communion between 10 and 11 on our front lawn as part of this digital worship experience, as well as you can continue at home if you are staying home. November 1st, it would be kind of when our new worship plan and life together will be communicated. We're sending out a survey. Check for the link both in your email, your MailChimp this week, as well as the Hope-Filled Happenings. And please just fill out that survey once. It's a simple 2 questions. Which would you most likely do, and which ones might you consider? There are some options there. We just want to be able to worship responsibly together, so we want to gather some information from you. And then looking ahead, November 1st is All Saints Sunday, so you can find on page 3 an invitation to email photos to media@crossofhope.org of your loved ones who have gone before us, pictures of baptisms as we celebrate all the saints on November 1st. Next week, I didn't mean to skip, is Reformation Sunday. Pastor Russ Sorensen, who's been helping lead and head up our small group ministries through this relaunch, if you will be preaching for us. I'm going to take a few days off with Laura this week and rest and recuperate. And so join us next week for Reformation Sunday and welcome Pastor Russ Sorensen. And then on page 6, you'll find information about a fundraiser for our school ministry, and it's one of my favorites because all you got to do is go eat at Chipotle. So you can find that information on page 6, one of my favorite places to go for a quick bite to eat. Dear friends, it continues to be on this journey together. Receive now God's blessing. Go out into the world in peace. Have courage. Hold on to what is good. Return no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted, support the weak, and help the suffering. Honor all people. Love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. The God the Creator, Jesus the Christ, and the Holy Spirit the Comforter, bless and keep you in eternal love. Amen.
Where you go, I'll go. Where you stay, I'll stay. When you move, I'll move. I will follow.
invite you to join me here at God's table with your bread and wine or grape juice there at home. I'll invite you to join me in these words of institution that's on your home resource, and then during the distribution to distribute to one another with the words body of Christ broken or given for you and blood of Christ shed for you. It is a blessing to gather around God's gifts for God's people. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, creator of the world. From the earth you give us bread to eat. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. Again after supper he took the cup, gave thanks. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, ruler of the universe. Through your goodness you give us the fruit of the vine. He gave it for all to drink, saying, This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me. Gathered here together by the Holy Spirit, we pray as Jesus taught. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Amen.
Consecrated, Lord, to Thee. Take my moments and my days. Let them flow in ceaseless praise. Take my hands and let them move at the impulse of Thy love. Take my feet and let them be swift and beautiful for Thee. My life that I may be consecrated, Lord, to Thee. Take my moments and my days, let them flow in ceaseless praise. Take my silver and my gold, not a mite could I withhold. Take my intellect and use every power as Thou shalt choose. My life that I may be consecrated, Lord, to Thee. Take my moments and my days, let them flow in ceaseless praise. Take my voice and let me sing, always only for my King. Take my lips and let them be filled with messages from Thee. Consecrated, Lord, to Thee. Take my moments and my days, let them flow in ceaseless praise. Take my will and make it Thine. It shall be no longer mine. Take my heart, it is Thine own. It shall be Thy royal throne. Take my life that I may be consecrated, Lord, to Thee. Take my moments and my days, let them flow in ceaseless praise.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. We give you thanks, gracious God, that you have once again fed us with food beyond compare, the body and blood of Christ. Lead us from this place, nourished and forgiven, into your beloved vineyard, to wipe away the tears of all who hunger and thirst, guided by the example of the same Jesus Christ, and led by the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you now and always. Let us go now in faith, sharing hopeful words of peace with one another and with the world.